Got some milk? Drink it to stay healthy. But is it really healthy? Today, we will be exploring, is milk even good for you?
After breastfeeding age, mammals usually do not consume milk, and humans at one point did not either. Only around 11,000 years ago did humans discover cow, goat, and sheep milk. Milk was a staple in our diet. Especially with the milk ad campaigns in the 90s and early 2000s, pushing for milk consumption. Although this is true, we can see a shift in the narrative now looking at the Canada Food Guide. In 2019, the Canada Food Guide was updated, removing dairy as a food group and promoting more vegan foods. In addition, many individuals have lactose sensitivity, as they do not have the enzyme lactase to break down the milk sugar lactose.
Additionally, we commonly see the signs of lactose intolerance as we grow older because the body loses the ability to produce lactase.
According to the U.S. National Library of Medicine, approximately 65% of the human population cannot digest lactose. Although this demonstrates that milk is not necessary for the human diet, what if you simply just want to still drink milk regardless? This video will further look at current research on milk consumption to allow you to determine that for yourself. There are some benefits as to why milk is essential for our diet. For example, milk can provide essential amino acids, vitamins, and minerals. Essential amino acids are building blocks for protein, which can only be taken from our diet. In addition, it is high in vitamin B, A, and C, which are necessary for bodily and bone processes. Milk is also a great source of minerals like calcium, magnesium, and zinc. One of the main components of milk is a protein called casein, which is a part of providing antimicrobial properties in minerals such as calcium, zinc, iron, and phosphate. Now we will be looking at some of the research demonstrating the cons of milk consumption.
Research has shown that the consumption of milk can contribute to the development of prostate cancer. Prostate cancer is the third most common type of cancer across the world and occurs when cells in the prostate rapidly divide and mutate, creating tumors that can potentially spread to other parts of the body. Another factor that can potentially cause prostate cancer is calcium. As too much of anything is good for nothing, consumption of high concentrations of calcium can also lead to the development of prostate cancer.
Cow's milk contains a contributor to prostate cancer called insulin-like growth factor, or IGF, which is a hormone that promotes bone and tissue development and growth. In a human study that was conducted, participants consumed cow's milk, and it resulted with an increased concentration of IGF, increasing the development of prostate cancer. Another study also showed that low-fat milk contributed to the development of mammary tumors.
These studies conclude that high concentrations of estrogen and IGF correlate with prostate cancer and breast cancer development.
Milk and hormones, ovulation. Although menarche, the age at which women reach sexual maturity, is mainly based on genetics, there are various environmental factors that can contribute to reaching menarche at an earlier age than most females. One of these environmental factors is diet. Research shows that there is a significant decrease in age for the menarche stage from 16 years to 13 years over time. One thing that can contribute to the time one reaches menarche is insulin-like growth factor, IGF. Synthetic hormones found in cow milk can be a contributing factor to increased IGF concentrations, thus leading to accelerating sexual maturation. Although the study shows that there was no correlation between intake of dairy fat consumption from milk and early menarche, there has been a positive correlation on the amount of calcium intake and the chances of having early menarche.
Milk and the environment.
According to an article published by Cambridge University, there are crucial increases in emission of methane gas from dairy cattle, and this therefore leads to the impact of climate change. About 0.2% of total carbon footprint comes from the production of milk, specifically the dairy feed production. This feed production contributes to 0.12% of the total emissions. The production of milk can also impact the environment through manure,
which can produce greenhouse gas emissions and feed onto climate change.
Now, you're probably wondering, how about milk alternatives? You might have seen nut milk like cashew and almond on the shelves, or even oat milk. Are these alternatives better than cow milk?
As you can see, there are multiple plant-based milk alternatives with both pros and cons to each. Feel free to pause this video and look at the pros and cons for each of the alternatives more in depth.
When looking at the plant-based alternatives in comparison to dairy milk, almond milk and rice milk have the most negative environmental impact. This is because almond milk uses the most water use, while rice milk has both high emissions and high water use.
Interestingly, one new alternative which may make its way to the shelf soon is lab milk. This milk is made in a laboratory without the use of any animals, but its composition is nearly identical to cow's milk. It is made by using a type of yeast to convert plant sugar into whey and casein, the two main cow milk proteins. While not widely available yet, the preliminary analysis of this lab milk has been found to be safe. It will contain the same nutrients as cow's milk once it's fortified and a similar protein level. One major benefit is that it would not have any lactose, making it suitable for lactose intolerant individuals.
Also, the production of this milk will emit significantly less greenhouse gases than producing cow's milk.
You're probably now thinking, so is milk even worth it? Well, that question is hard to answer, since it depends on many personal factors. You have to decide whether it is right for you. As mentioned, there are many dietary benefits. It is also an integral part of many foods available in the market like yogurt and cheese, making it quite integrated into our society. In addition, it is valuable to recognize that milk also is significant in some cultures, meaning it might not be appropriate for everyone to stop drinking cow's milk. Finally, there's also a huge accessibility concern. Cow's milk might be the only option in your certain geographical location. So, whether milk is worth it or not depends on each person and their situation.